In this lecture, we will study about the effective mass of electrons or holes. So, before discussing about effective mass, let us first see how an electron moves in a metal. In this figure, you can see that there are two EK diagrams. In first diagram, there is no applied electric field, but in this diagram, there is an applied electric field. And we know that for a metal, valence band and conduction band overlap to each other. And in this diagram, we can see that in an or in the absence of an electric field, due to symmetry in crystal, there are as many electrons moving in right direction as they are moving in left direction. So the motion of the electron at each energy cancel each other as for A and B. In this way, no net current is available in the absence of an electric field. In this diagram or figure, we can see that when there is no applied electric field, the electrons moving with positive momentum is similar in number to that moving with minus momentum, or the number of electrons moving in right direction is equal to the number of electrons moving in left direction. So the electrons moving at point B with some energy, and this momentum of electron cancel the momentum of this electron, or the net momentum on this energy level is zero. So in this way, there is no net momentum when we not applied any electric field. So there is no net current available. But when an electric field EX is applied to a metal, an electron near the Fermi level can gain energy from the field and move to higher energy level the momentum state it's very important point the momentum state vacated by A is filled by the electron immediately below which now gains energy and move up and so on. An electron that is moving in the minus x direction gets decelerated and hence loses energy as indicated by B moving to point B prime. Here the electrons moving in the positive x direction gain energy and those are moving in the minus x direction lose energy. Therefore, whole electron momentum distribution shifts in the positive direction, positive x direction, and results in a net electric current. So if we go back to that diagram, when we applied an electric field to the metal, the electrons near to the Fermi level gain energy and go to the higher energy state. Just that electron at point A now gets energy from the field and goes to this point A prime. And now other electrons that are in the lower energy states now get energy and go to higher energy state. And at the same time, the electron with negative momentum or at point B now gets deaccelerated and moves in downward direction. So in this way, these electrons are getting energy and these electrons are losing energy. So there is a shift in the overall momentum, and in this way we get an electric current when we applied an electric field. So electrons can get energy from the applied electric field, and in this way there is an electric current in the metal. So now we consider an electron in vacuum. So now let's consider an electron in vacuum. If I draw some sketch, or I can use some stylus. There is vacuum in this box. So if this is an electron and if Ex is the similar to the example that I have used in earlier case. If EX is the applied electric field on the electron, then external force on the electron would be so. Now again I'm coming to this diagram. This is vacuum and this is an electron in this vacuum system. So now there is an applied electric field EX in this direction. So now due to this electric field, this electron will gain energy and will move in this direction. And if I write A is the acceleration of this electron, then this would be F external, which is equal to E EX, where FEXT is the external force on an electron due to the applied electric field. And if this electron gets an acceleration A, then F external would be equal to MEA. Where ME is the mass of electron in vacuum. Or we can write from this equation A, which is equal to FEXT by ME. So when we applied an electric field EX on an electron in vacuum, then electron gets an acceleration A, which is equal to FEXT by ME. So this is the case of vacuum. Now let's consider an electron in a crystal. First, let me draw a crystal, and we know that In a crystal, there are periodic arrangement of the atoms or ions with positive charges. So there are periodic arrangement of atoms and now let's take an electron with negative charge. We know that this electron is bounded by these atoms. And due to this boundation, there is an internal force on this electron. And as we applied an external applied field in previous example, now let's apply the same electric field in this case. So due to this external electric field, this electron gains an acceleration in this direction, and let's say this acceleration is CRYST, that is acceleration in this crystal. So now when an electron in the crystal, there are two forces. First one is external forces, that is due to this applied electric field, and another force is F internal due to these atoms. So here the if we write a formula like this, so this acceleration in crystal should be equal to FEXT plus FINT by ME. So if you write a simple formula for acceleration, then acceleration should be like this. So here one important thing is that F internal is the sum of all the internal forces acting on the electron. And another important thing is that now for external force, that is FEXT, the electron will appear to be having a different inertial mass, since its acceleration will be different. Meaning is that for getting same acceleration A as we got earlier, we have to apply some different external force. Since there is an internal force that is acting on this electron. So now this electric force or this electric field counters an electron that seems to be having different inertial mass. So now we have to consider these things for getting this type of formula. So it would be easier for us if the effect of the internal forces in FINT would be accounted in a simple way. Since we don't know the nature of forces that are acting on the electron in a crystal, but still we want a simple expression, mathematical expression, to get acceleration, force and these things. And this is due to the fact that a simple mathematical formula as we used in earlier case would be used for calculation of acceleration. Due to external force only. And this is indeed possible. So in this formula we can see there is an extra term of FINT and we want to omit this term and we want to change this formula in such a way that we only have to calculate this acceleration due to external force only or external applied field only, and we don't want to care this FINT or this internal force. So this is possible. Because in a crystal, atoms are arranged periodically and hence their effect on electron are also periodic in nature. A simple formula that only having the part of external applied field can be used, because atoms in the crystal are arranged in a periodic fashion, and in this way their effects on electron are also periodic in nature. Therefore, we can predict the effect of atoms on electrons and when we solve Schrodinger equation with periodic potential, air potential means potential energy, we essentially obtain the effects of these internal forces on the electron. On the electron motion. And it is worth to note that when the electron is in a band that is not full, we can still use the above equation, that is equal to F EXT by ME, but instead of ME we must use the effective mass, that is ME star. Of the electron. in that particular crystal. The effective mass is a quantum mechanical quantity that behaves in the same way as the inertial mass in classical mechanics. Meaning is that by considering the internal force part, that is in this formula, if we replace this quantity somehow by any mean, since there is periodic potential in a crystal, so due to that periodic potential we can predict the nature of the effect of that potential on the electron. So we can use this same formula for getting acceleration, but instead of having this ME in this formula, we have to replace this ME with effective mass that include this whole part. So simply we can write a crystal which is equal to FEXT ME star. So this is the acceleration by this external force FEXT of an electron in a crystal with effective mass ME star. And we can say that here effects of all the internal forces are incorporated into ME star, which is effective mass of the electron. Now let's relate this effective mass with energy. And we know that E, that is energy which is equal to h cross square by k square E, which is equal to h cross square k square by 2 m e. So now in a crystal, instead of m e, we replace this by effective mass. So here this effective mass has a relation with k and e. So to make a direct relation with E, we can differentiate this equation by K. So in first differentiation dE by dK, which is equal to 2 h cross square K by 2 ME star, and these two are get cancelled out. So now this is equal to h cross K by m e star, and if we differentiate one more time, then this would be d square e by d k square, which is equal to h cross square by m e star. So from here we can write that 1 by m e star, which is equal to one by h cross square into d square e by d k square. So this is the relation of effective mass with the energy. Here we can see that the second derivative of E with respect to K is inversely proportional to the effective mass. For the case of free electron, the mass of the or the mass is a constant. So the second derivative function is a constant. Since we know that this is the EK diagram or EK graph, this is E and this is K, and if we take second derivative of this and 1 by or when we take second derivative of this graph, then we get a constant. So therefore the effective mass of free electron is a constant. And the second derivative of this free electron is also positive. It means the mass of a free electron is always positive. And by replacing this by H, we can write a similar equation for whole effective mass. However, holes have or holes can have two types of effective mass. One is known as heavy hole and other are light holes, and that part we will take in another lecture. So from this lecture we understand that in a crystal where internal forces due to atoms are present, we can write a simple Newtonian formula for getting acceleration of electron. But instead of simple free electron mass, we have to replace this free electron mass with effective mass, and value of this effective mass depends upon the nature of the crystal. It can be more than the free electron mass, it can be negative or it can be positive. So finally we can get an effective mass which is inversely proportional to the second derivative of the energy with respect to k.